So, hello everyone, my name is Erased, and today I'm bringing you a little tutorial on the Porter Robinson's new single, Lionhearted. I really like the song, so I decided to recreate it in FL Studio using mainly Silent One. So, anyway, let's get started. First we're gonna listen to the whole drop, which I have recreated here. So, this is what the ending result will be like. So, it's not completely accurate, but I think it's pretty close to the original one. So, we're gonna start by actually not listening to the whole synths and all this stuff here. We're gonna go through the percussions. So, this is not how it actually goes, but what I have made here is here I've got my kick drum. This is the like the lower part, and this is a like a little top kick. And this is what they sound like. So yeah, that's my kick drum. This one I actually got from my friend who made it for me. Thank you, Useless Parents, for making this. And this one I just took from a Vengeance. Vengeance, the you know, the dubstep package number 2. So that's a kick drum, and what I have here is the snare, and it's just a regular little snare, also taken from a Vengeance package, another one. And I've also got this other one, which is like this. So like that. Next up we've got my my hi-hats. So yes, sorry for that. So here are my hi-hats and my other cymbals, and they sound like this. Pretty simple, nothing too fancy here, just some a few other a few different hi-hats here, all taken from the Vengeance package. So next up I've got my my noise here, white noise, and it's just basically this. Yeah, and I've got some side chaining on that. Also I've got this impact here. And there's some more side chaining too, and a little crash here, and a longer cymbal kind of downfielder filter here. Nothing too long, nothing too fancy, pretty self-explanatory all this. But what's pretty awesome about this is the synths themselves. So what I've got here is, first of all, I've got these two, which are almost the identical synths, but the other one has a higher octave version, and another one which is completely pan to the middle, which I've got in here. I've got one pan to the left and one pan to the right. And on top of that, first I will show you what they sound like. So they're like this. So yeah, that's a melody, you all know it. I recreated by ear. It's nothing really that complicated. And also I've got this sub here. And on top of that, I've got this little bass going on here. Nothing too fancy that too. And the last thing I have here is my, actually I'm using Nexus here, this dance piano 2K7. And I'm using it as the piano in the drop, and it sounds like this. Yeah, that's not too complicated either. And on this other pattern, I've got this number 2. It's got a little bit more volume on the piano, so it actually sounds like this. Yeah, so that's the whole thing. Nothing too fancy here. But what we're gonna do now is I'm gonna show you how to make this. Since these two, I have been looking through YouTube and forums and Reddit all over the place for tutorials on this this synth here. But sorry for that. I just can't find anything. So I just decided to use my awesome skills and recreate the sound. So we're actually gonna make another synth here, and we're going to mute everything else, and I'm gonna show you how we do this. Okay, so we're gonna start from the oscillator 1, and we're just gonna pump up the volume. And this is an important part here. Many from the remakes I've seen on YouTube, they use just regular super sauce, so something like that. But or you mean even more. But what I found out is that actually the Lionhearted synth doesn't have that much detune, so it's acted like this. That's like pretty basics here, and we're gonna copy that exact thing over here, and we're gonna pan them, the other one to the left and the other one to the right, and we're gonna pump up some release from the amp envelope. So next up, we're actually gonna make the arpeggiating sound the synth has. So we're gonna turn it on and put the chord on so it plays all the notes simultaneously, and see, it's a bit slow, so we're gonna put it here. Yeah, and then we're gonna increase the gate into about 70%. So yeah, what I've then done is, this is actually really important, the distortion part. The synth has, in the original song, it has so much distortion. So what we're gonna do first is we're going to increase the amount a bit, and we're gonna choose clip here and make even like the dry wet somewhere around 65%. This is like, you don't have to do the exact things I make, this is just how I made it. So just bear with me and do your own stuff however you like it. Next up, we're gonna use the chorus, just a little bit of chorus. I'm not sure if the song actually has it, but I just like the sound when it gets a little bit wider. So don't be afraid, that sounds a little, like actually really bad at the moment, but let's just put this here and listen to this. Yep, doesn't sound too good now, does it? I'm just gonna take it a little bit down, and what we're gonna do now is hit the reverb, and we're gonna reduce the size and a little bit of the pre-delay, a little more damp, that's more dry, and let's do that. And then compression, we're gonna around there. You can play with this yourself. There's nothing too complicated. Next up, we're gonna turn on a filter. So we're gonna go to a low pass filter, and we're gonna keep it like this, a little bit of resonance around here, and increase the drive. I really love the silence drive, it brings so much warmth to the sound. So yeah, that's about it. Now we're gonna turn on the warm drive. A little bit of resonance I like to put, and a little bit of key tracking. So yeah, that's the basic sound actually. And then we're gonna use this mod envelope number one, put on a little bit of decay, and a little bit of this. Now, that's basically the whole synth, there's nothing really anything to put there. This is the first one I made. As you can see, it's actually pretty similar, there's nothing too crazy going on except for the noise which we could add into here. Let's put on a number one, and it's way too loud, so we're gonna do this, and then copy this one. And that's basically all we have to do. I like to increase the mix A a little bit, so it's a little bit more louder than the basic noise here. But now you're thinking like, but that doesn't really sound like the synthesizer. It doesn't sound like this. And this is where the effects come in. So we're gonna check this one, this since effects slots, and we've got a ton of stuff here. Nothing too complicated again. So we're gonna go first with the sidechaining by Crossbeat. I like the volume sidechaining a lot. It's much clearer in my opinion, and I've used this alternative double curve to create this awesome sidechaining. As you know, that volume pumping up and down. Next up, I added a little bit of sausage fender, and it really makes a difference if you can. Wow, that clipping. Just some more volume and some compression and a little bit of distortion there. And next up, we're gonna put on a Camel Crusher, this other one I'm not using at the moment. And we're going to take the tube warmth patch. Well, that's how I began with mine, and then I started fiddling around with this distortion. So I've taken the mech all the way off, and the tube around 20%, not too much. And that actually makes a huge difference in the sound. My CPU seems to be breaking, so I have no idea why it's lagging this much. And this is a really important step here, the through the limiter. Without this, it sounds way too rough and clips a lot, so you have to put a through the limiter, and it actually makes a huge difference. So just listen to this. I have no idea why it's lagging that much at the moment, but so yeah, that's basically the first synthesizer. The other one is basically the exact same. It's actually in the same effect slot here. It's just got this one like a higher octave in the first oscillator, and the other one is panned to the middle, whereas these two were panned to the left, and yeah, panned to the left and panned to the right. So yeah, next up we have my bass and my sub bass. So basically it's just, yeah, nothing crazy. Oh yeah, and remember to put this stereo here, put it down. You want to have your bass sounds as mono. So simple as that. And the next one I'm not gonna recreate because it's so goddamn simple to make. So it's basically just a -2 octave saw with 8 voices and the retrick on, and another sub here, and then we've just got this filter here. This is so simple, I know everyone can do this. And I put a little bit of chorus and a little bit of reverb again. And also this mod envelope is which makes it so bouncy. So it sounds like this actually. A little small difference. I've made the notes here, like I don't know, are the 16th notes? I believe so. But yeah, that's what that's basically the whole song, well, the whole drop of the Lionhearted by Porter Robinson, and we're going to end this by listening to my whole drop here. I'm just gonna turn this one off, and this is what it's supposed to sound like. Okay, I'm not gonna show you how what it sounds like right now. I'm gonna edit a little what is it called, a exported track on the end of the video, because for some reason my computer is starting to break. But hey, anyways, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.